Hey guys, welcome to Under the Sun, where we talk about everything that is happening under the sun. Today, we're going to talk about the second kanda of the epic Ramayana, the Ayodhya Kanda. Ayodhya Kanda is about the preparations of the Ram's coronation as a prince, the coronation and his exile into the forest. In Ayodhya Kanda, Raja Dasharath dies due to the grief. King Dasharath, who had grown old, expressed his desire to install Ram, his eldest child, the Yuvraj, known as Prince Regent, to which the Kolasa assembly and his subjects expressed their support. He decided that the next day he would begin the ceremony for the installation of Ram as the Prince Regent. The demigods and Mother Earth became very concerned that Ram was becoming very settled in Ayodhya, and something had to happen if Ram was to conquer Ravan. They approached Goddess Saraswati for help. Saraswati decided to alter the mind state of one of the Queen Kaikeyi's maid servant called Mantara, doing what was necessary to ensure that Ram would come into conflict with Ravan. Mantara's mind became twisted and began to talk to Queen Kaikeyi in harsh terms. Mantara, a family servant of Kaikeyi, she lived with her from the time of her birth. When she heard that King Dasharath was planning to make his eldest son, Ram, Prince Regent, she fled into rage and reported the news to Kaikeyi. Kaikeyi was initially pleased. Mantara convinced her that if Ram came to power, he would exile or kill Bharat in order to eliminate a possible threat to his power. Slowly, Queen Kaikeyi's mind was poisoned. Mantara reminded Queen Kaikeyi of the two boons that the king had promised her. Kaikeyi entered the sulking chamber into the royal palace and awaited for King Dasharath. King Dasharath was greatly alarmed and concerned that Kaikeyi was in the sulking chamber, as the entire population of Ayodhya was greatly happy and eagerly anticipating the coronation of Ram. Queen Kaikeyi spoke to King Dasharath, which surprised the king. She reminded him of the two boons long ago he promised her and claimed two boons. This happened when King Dasharath was wounded in his chariot on the battlefield once, and Kaikeyi saved his life by taking over the reins and driving the chariot to safety. The heartbroken king, constrained by his rigid devotion to his given word, Kaikeyi asked these two boons from King Dasharath. All arrangements had been made for Ram's coronation. Instead, let my son, Bharat, be crowned as Prince Regent on this occasion itself. Ram had to take refuge in the forest for 14 years. The king's court assistant Sumantara sent Ram to his father. Queen Kaikeyi spoke to Ram and explained the boons that she had asked of his father. Ram accepted his father's reluctant decree with absolute submission and his stepmother's request, and decided to leave the kingdom as it served all the purposes of his reincarnation. Ram was joined by Sita and Lakshman. Ram tried to convince Sita not to join him in a dangerous jungle. Sita replied, "The forest where you dwell is Ayodhya for me, and Ayodhya without you is a veritable hell for me." When Ram ordered her in his capacity as a husband, Sita rejected it, asserting that it was an essential duty of a wife to be at her husband's side, come good or bad. Ram, Sita, and Lakshman greet their mothers before finally going to Dasharath to take leave of him. Dasharath attempted in vain to try to talk Sita out of joining Ram in the forest. After Ram's departure, King Dasharath narrated to Kausalya his earliest sin committed by him in his young age. When he was the Prince Regent of Ayodhya, he was famous for who can shoot heard but unseen objects at the sound of the movement of the object by an arrow. One day, he went out for hunting in the forest along Sarayu River, excepting wild animals coming there for drinking water in the night. He mistook the gurgling sound for the trumpeting of an elephant, released a sharp arrow in the direction where a hermit boy was filling his pitcher with water by submerging it into the Sarayu River. Arrow hit the boy that went deep into the body, and after hearing his cry, he reached the place. He discovered the fatal blunder and tendered his heartfelt apologies to the hermit boy who had come there for fetching water for his old parents. Boy asked Dasharath to extract the arrow from his body and said, "My name is Shravan. My parents are old and blind. I am taking them to pilgrimage. My parents are waiting for me at a distance. I was here to fetch water for them. I am their only support. Now I am worried that they may not survive after hearing the news of my death." The boy died soon after the arrow was drawn out from the body. Then King Dasharath went to the aged parents of the deceased boy and informed about the death of their son and its cause. He brought them to their son to the river where he was lying dead. Aged couple cursed the king that he too would die of agony caused by the separation from his son. The aged couple gave up their lives. After narrating the story of him getting a curse long back, King Dasharath started weeping loudly. The residents of Ayodhya joined Ram, Sita, Lakshman into the bank of River Tamasa. Ram, Sita, Lakshman and Sumandara escaped from the citizens during the deep night and ventured further into the forest towards the Sringavarapur, where they met Guha, the Nishat king. They arrived at Prayag. Ram met with the king Bharadwaj at his ashram. Lord Ram then met Rishi Valmiki, the author of Ramayana, at Chitrakoot. Ram asked Sumantara to return to Ayodhya. On returning to Ayodhya, Dasharath asked Sumantara of the whereabouts of Ram. The pain of separation from Ram was too much for king that he passed away crying Ram's name. Bharat and Shatrughan, who were on a visit to their maternal uncle in Kekaya country, were unaware of what was happening in Ayodhya. Rishi Vasishtha knew that Ram would not return back to the kingdom, so he had immediately sent an envoy to call Bharat and Shatrughan back to Ayodhya. Bharat learned of all that had happened and criticized his mother, Queen Kaikeyi. He accused her of bringing ruin to the family. They approached Queen Kausalya and Bharat begged for her forgiveness. She asked him to carry out his duty and rule Ayodhya. But Bharat could not bear the thought of sitting on the throne with his father dead and his brothers in exile in the forest. The cremation of the king Dasharath took place. Bharat and Shatrughan decided to go into the forest and request Ram to return to Ayodhya and take the throne. Prominent citizens as well as the royal family decided to go with Bharat and Shatrughan. The Nishat saw the approaching royal party and became suspicious and informed Lakshman. Lakshman saw the huge army of people with Bharat and immediately began to criticize Bharat. Ram countered this by praising the greatness of Bharat. Bharat arrived at the Chitrakoot and met Ram there. All the brothers collectively mourned the passing of their father and performed his Shraddh along with Rishi Vasishtha leading the ceremony. Despite Bharat's convincing, Ram found it impossible that he could break the word of his dead father and the stepmother Kaikeyi. Bharat gave up his efforts to take Ram back to Ayodhya before the 14-year exile elapsed. Bharat returned to Ayodhya after receiving a promise from Ram that he would return promptly at the end of 14 years of exile and ascend the throne. He vowed to Ram that if Ram did not return immediately when the 14-year elapses, he would give his life up for immolation. Bharat agreed to govern Ayodhya not as its leader, but as Ram's representative. On giving his sandals to Bharat for custodial care of kingdom till his return after the period of exile, Bharat, after touching Ram's feet and taking sandals, he returned from Chitrakoot. And without ruling from Ayodhya, he carried on from the kingdom from a village called Nandigram. Ram, Sita and Lakshman wandered in the forest and came across the hermitage of Atri. Sita was embraced by Atri's wife Anasuya and told Sita at great length about the duties of a devoted wife. Ram, Sita and Lakshman entered the forest called Dandaka and encountered the demon Virada. Virada attempted to capture Sita, but Ram eliminated the demon. Ram, after eliminating demon Virada, entered the hermitage of Rishi Sarbhanga. Rishi Sarbhanga, with his sixth sense, came to know that Vishnu was coming his way and would become his dear guest. He received Ram in his hermitage. After seeing Ram, Sita and Lakshman, and also showing the next course of their journey, that Rishi entered the yogic fire and ascended to Brahma abode. Ram, Sita, Lakshman arrived at the hermitage of Rishi Sutisnika. After spending night in the hermitage of Rishi Sutisnika, the next morning, bidding farewell to them, Rishi Sutisnika expressed concern about the demonic activities in the Dandaka Aranya, by whom these forests have been turned stockyards for heaps of dead bodies, bones and skulls of the rishis. Continuing on their journey from the forest, Ram, Sita, Lakshman entered to the hermitage of Rishi Agastya. Rishi was also waiting to receive Ram for a long time and received them with all the honors, perceiving Ram as Vishnu's incarnate. Rishi Agastya gave a divine bow of Vishnu, two quivers with ever replenishing with arrows, and a golden sword to Ram, saying that with the same armory, Vishnu once eradicated evil on earth. Ram requested Rishi Agastya to suggest a place in the forest to make the residence during the days of exile. Rishi Agastya foresaw the next course of Ramayana and oriented his conversation around the womanhood and Sita. Then Rishi Agastya informed Ram to proceed to Panchavati, where Sita would be delightful of its surroundings. Ram, Sita and Lakshman, on their way to Panchavati, came into contact with Jatayu, the mighty eagle, informed Ram that he was a friend of King Dasharath and would help him in exile. Please like, comment, share and subscribe to Under the Sun.